everyone, it's me Aisha Khan here, and today we are going to talk about play. So basically when we start talking about playing, parents are too conscious of generation that allowed too little time to play. And pediatricians have also highly recommended play as an essential component for healthy brain development. So basically today I'm going to highlight some main points regarding play which have been developed by American sociologists. So let's move on to my presentation and read some main points.
Is not play is not a child, yes, naturally. So the play consists of healthy brain development, yes, we all know that very important thing it is, and while developing their imagination, physical, cognitive and emotional strength, it really works all together. Why play is important? Play is important to healthy brain development. Again, there definitely it's really important point, it is, that's why everywhere. At a very early age, a child engage and interact in the world around them. Yes, when the child is playing with a toy or with a group of children, they start observing everything. We are going to talk about the types of play on early year childhood, which we can observe them on their ages while they are playing, whether they are playing alone or together. So the types of play are unoccupied play, independent or solitary play, onlooker play, parallel play, associative play, cooperative play. These types of play are applicable for age 2 to 5. The observations are done on the early year childhood. So we are going to discuss that. Unoccupied play is basically a play of infancy where the baby is playing and whatever the baby is doing is called play. And recommended toys for them are soft stuffed toys. Independent play is basically the child plays all alone, and it's really incredible important age that you cannot force them to bond properly from with the new environment or comfortable. If they are not with anyone, they cannot play. Onlooker play is when your child observes the play of other children while not actually playing themselves. You can do a good job for them to take them to the park and make them sit, and they can observe nicely to other children how they are doing and how they are playing with the toys and with other children's. Parallel play, though they may use the same toys, your child plays beside rather than with other children. Toys that can be shared easily are ideal. Your child is one step closer to understanding how to connect with people outside of their family. So slowly it's processing how the child is interacting with other children. Associative play is basically your child plays with other children, but the kids do not organize their play towards a common goal. Kids generally become more capable of handling small toys at around age of 3. Cooperative play, basically the age of 5, you can say, they start beginning of teamwork. Your kids play with other for a common purpose. This is a final developmental age. 9 amazing benefits of play. Play stimulates brain growth, enhances early development. Play improves intelligence. Play sparks creative thinking for sure. Link to communication, vocabulary, language, learning and visual spatial skills. Pretend play facilitates impulse control and emotion regulation. Pretend play improves social competence and empathy. And there are so many other points, you can read out it from there. I just missed it because my presentation just finished. I hope you like my video. Do subscribe my channel and do wait for my good new videos. Thank you so much.